students, a very good morning to you.
Today we will study
chapter 12, that is biotechnology and its application, and today's topic is biotechnological application in medicine. In our last class we have studied that how biotechnology help in agriculture. So here we will study about application in medicine, how biotechnology help us providing different facilities in producing medicine. So first we will study, this is the most interesting topic in this whole chapter, and I hope you all can understand at its first attempt. So first one is your first topic is genetically engineered insulin. But before we going to study genetically engineered insulin, first we have to know how the biotechnological application helps in medicine. So at present 30 recombinant DNAs are developed which are used in medicine. Out of 12 recombinants are marketed in India. So India has 12 out of 30 recombinant DNAs used as medicine and marketed in India. So out of these, one of them is genetically engineered insulin. There is one question arise in your mind, what is insulin, what is its importance, where it comes. So first, as we know, pancreas is the dual gland that is present in all mammals which secretes insulin, and insulin helps in maintaining the sugar level in our blood. So what will happen if a person is unable to secrete enough insulin or less insulin? In this case, you must say the patient have to introduce extra insulin from outside to fulfill the requirement of body, means to control the sugar level. So before or long ago, persons who lacks insulin or who have no mature insulin, they used the insulin of other animals such as slaughtered cattle and pigs. Slaughtered cattle and pigs means dead cattle and pigs. By killing them, insulin is produced from the finding from them, and they are introduced into human beings. You think if the animal's insulin is injected to us or go into our body must show some symptoms, means some allergic reactions and some other disorders, skin disorders, itching, etc. So to overcome from this problem, nowadays genetically formed insulin is discovered. First we have to understand how insulin formed in pancreas. Listen, insulin is not directly formed. Insulin is present in its pro form, which is called propane insulin. So let's understand this through this graph. This is the chain of a pro insulin. This is the chain of a pro insulin, and this has three peptide chains. This peptide chain is C, this one is B, and this one is A. You can say A, B, and C. And these three combined by the help of sulfur, means disulfide bonding. So this is proinsulin, means initially formed in the pancreas. It have to get matured for functioning in the body. So what happened? When the proinsulin get matured, the C peptide from it get detached, means the C peptide chain is released, and A and B are joined to form a mature insulin. In this way, our body forms mature insulin. So what is the difference between proinsulin? Simply, in proinsulin, A, B and C peptide are present, but in mature insulin, C peptide is separated from A and B. This is the main difference between proinsulin and mature insulin. So in mature insulin, A peptide and B peptide also combined or joined by disulfide bonding. So to perform the same activity, nowadays biotechnology developed many techniques. In the year 1983, American company Eli Lilly first invented or made genetically engineered insulin. So how this insulin engineered? As we know here, the proinsulin has to be matured, or in the patient which lacks insulin, maybe it forms proinsulin, but the proinsulin can't get matured. So here, using E. coli, as you know, E. coli is the best vector for cloning of any desirable piece of gene or DNA. So first, A peptide is formed, separately formed, B peptide is separately formed, and they put separately in E. coli. And when the chain is formed, again they are combined by the help of disulfide bond, and new mature insulin is produced, which is nowadays used. This is given by or given through injections. So remember, in 1983, first time American company Eli Lilly was prepared the genetically engineered insulin, in which A peptide and B peptide are separately grow and put in the E. coli, in which they grow and combine. After that, they put in the sulfur disulfide bonding and combine to form mature insulin. This is how nowadays we able to control or reduce our sugar level in the blood for those persons who are suffering from diabetes or hyperglycemia. So next topic is our gene therapy. What do you mean by gene therapy? Gene therapy means when any person is treated by replacing its gene. Suppose, for example, if one person is suffering from any genetical disease, then we can find out that gene in which the disease causing factor is present, and we can remove it, or we can manipulate some desirable characters in it. So here what happened, gene therapy first time in 1990, remember, in 1990, a four year girl child was treated by this therapy. This child lacks ADA, adenosine deaminase, the enzyme named as ADA, adenosine deaminase. The patient lacks adenosine deaminase, due to which its immune system is completely weak, or she may suffer from any other disease due to lack of or due to low immune system. So in this case, what should do? We can replace the gene, or can be treated by giving the enzyme that is adenosine deaminase, by giving it to the bone marrow, or we can treated it through giving bone marrow transplantation. But here, these are not the permanent cure, because if this treatment is done in the early embryonic stage or in the child, then we can improve and we can able to cure this disease. So here, gene therapy and the gene replaced is ADA, adenosine deaminase. So this girl child was suffered from low immune system due to lack of the synthesis of this enzyme. This enzyme or this disease can be treated by the help of enzyme therapy or gene therapy. So next is your molecular diagnosis. What do you mean by diagnosis? Diagnosis, I think you all know what is diagnosis. Diagnosis means When a doctor checks a person, he or she ask about what are the symptoms of the disease. So this is diagnosis, means proper checkup of the body, both physical, physiological and internal problems of the body. So molecular diagnosis means molecular diagnosis means by detecting the cell where the disease causing factor is present. So in molecular diagnosis, there are different techniques are evolved or prepared by biotechnological application, which is our topic. So in this case, different techniques like your PCR, which is called polymerase chain reaction, then your ELISA, enzyme linked immune servant assay, ELISA. So these techniques help us to identify many deadly diseases like AIDS, cancer, etc. So how this helps? This helps, listen one thing, when we saw some symptoms of disease, at that stage the microbes or the antigens enter into our body have already increased their number. Then we saw symptoms, means when any microorganism is present inside our body, we can't say that we are suffer from that disease, because we ourselves unable to identify till we not saw any symptoms. And when we saw some symptoms, then the microorganisms completely covers our body, completely increases their number in our body. So in this case, what should do? So listen, in this case, a single stranded DNA or RNA is tagged with a probe. A single stranded DNA or RNA, you know, these are called probe, is allowed to hybridize to form or to its complementary DNA in a clone of cells, followed by using autoradiography. Remember, a piece of DNA or a piece of RNA is called a probe, which you already studied in chapter 6. What is a probe? Probe is a piece of DNA or RNA. Here, a piece of DNA or RNA is hybridized or tagged. Then, through autoradiography. What do you mean by autoradiography? Autoradiography is the picture taken by X-ray films or based on X-ray. So, in this case, the mutated gene will not show any complementary. That's why we can able to identify that where the gene is affected, the cell is affected, or where the cell is affected or not. And next technique is your ELISA, enzyme linked immune servant assay. And remember, this works on the principle of antigen antibody interaction or antibody antigen interaction. What do you this means? What does this means? This means that we can able to identify any disease in its early stage by giving or introducing some antigens against it. When antigen enters into our body, then the antibodies get activated. And when the antibodies get activated, we can able to know that some disease causing factors are growing. So simply you can remember, antigen antibodies are detected or synthesized. Antibody is synthesized against antigens when they are introduced into our body. So these are the biotechnological application in medicine. First, I have told you about genetic engineered insulin. Second is gene therapy, and third is molecular diagnosis, which includes PCR and ELISA. PCR is used to detect in its early stage any disease like AIDS, cancer, etc. And ELISA is another technique to identify any disease, and ELISA is based on antibody and antigen interaction. Next topic is our transgenic animal. First, you have to understand transgenic animal. So As you know, nowadays coronavirus, the effect of coronavirus in the whole world.
So,
many countries are trying to make vaccine against this virus. So, how the vaccine is prepared? What is the procedure to test it on different animals? So, you can understand all these things after studying this topic, transgenic animals. First, transgenic animal are those animals whose gene is altered by a desirable gene. Means the animal works something different against or when compared to normal animals. They are normal animals, but they have some extra gene manipulated or introduced in them, due to which they show extra character from the normal animals. So, what are their uses and in which field these transgenic animals are used? You understand transgenic animals? Transgenic animals are those animals whose gene is, or in which a desirable piece of gene is introduced, due to which they show some extra character than the normal organism. So, first point is normal physiology and development. So, transgenic animals are used to study normal physiology and development. So, what is normal physiology and development? Suppose, for example, if one person is taking insulin, then how its body responds to it? How its body responds to it? Whether it shows some reactions against it, whether the other organs of the body getting affected or not. So, to study these physiological characters, transgenic animals are helpful. Next is study of disease. Nowadays, by using transgenic animal, we can able to study many diseases, such as cystic fibrosis. This disease also you have studied in chapter 5, cystic fibrosis is the disease. Then your rheumatoid arthritis, Alzheimer's disease, cancer, etc. So, rheumatoid arthritis, you also know what is rheumatoid arthritis. I have told you in chapter 8. This is the disease that old age person suffers, joint pains. This is an autoimmune disorder. Autoimmune disease means our body, when we get old or when we grow older, then our self cells are identified, the own cells, and they kill them, due to which we suffer from many diseases. One of them is your rheumatoid arthritis. So, we can study many diseases by using transgenic animals like cancer, cystic fibrosis, rheumatoid arthritis, and Alzheimer's disease. So, next is your biological products. Next, transgenic animals. We are studying about transgenic animals which are made due to biotechnology, and their function is different. First, here we study how they help us to know the normal physiology and development. Second, here we know to study many diseases. And third one, we are going to study, that is biological products. What do you mean by biological products? Biological products means the products that are obtained from living organism. Biological products are those products which are obtained from living organisms. So, how they help us to study biological products? Here you should understand that how they help. So, first one is your transgenic animal that produce useful biological product can be introduced or can be get by a piece of DNA which contains the gene. So here the biological product is alpha 1 antitrypsin. That biological product is used to treat emphysema. Emphysema is the disease, the respiratory disease, which may be treated by using the biological product that is alpha 1 antitrypsin. Remember this term, alpha 1 antitrypsin is the biological product which is used to treat emphysema. And next one, you have heard about the Rosie cow in 1997. The first transgenic cow, Rosie, was developed in which, listen, in which the extra product or the extra quality that we get is alpha lacta albumin. The name is alpha lacta albumin. What is its character? Alpha lacta albumin is equivalent with human protein. Alpha lacta albumin is equivalent with human protein. The protein that is found in human milk or mother's milk. This gene, when a gene is introduced into a normal cow, then it able to produce the milk that contain this protein. So the first transgenic cow, Rosie cow, produces 1 liter of milk. 1 liter of milk in which the amount of human protein is 2.4 gram. Human protein is 2.4 gram, which is very nutritious to the infants or newborn childs, and they can get the human milk protein. This is how we can able to get biological products. Next is vaccine safety. Again, I am going to discuss about coronavirus, because there are many countries trying to form or make the vaccine of coronavirus. So when coronavirus will be formed or prepared, how its safety is detected? Here also transgenic animals are used. How? Listen, when polio vaccine was discovered, then it is directly not injected to human child, because here some transgenic animals are made with the testing of vaccines first done in them. So as transgenic animal, we can use, or the animals used are mice, rabbit, monkey, fish, etc. So this dose is first injected to in these animals. So you have must some questions arise, why these animals choose? Because the vaccine is test can't be tested on human beings because of their safety. So these animals are choose. And the next is, they all are mammals and we are also mammals. So when we introduced a gene in them, they are uncommon and to tolerate the vaccine. So here, when the vaccine is developed, it is goes through different testings, and those testings are done in the transgenic animals like your polio vaccine. And same will happen in case of the vaccine that is the scientists are trying to make for coronavirus also. First they will try on mice, then rabbit, then monkey, then will try on human beings. Okay, like China is practicing on the people of Pakistan. So let's move to our next topic, that is chemical safety testing. Chemical safety testing means here the toxicity testing. Toxicity means when we take some medicine that react in our body, or when we use a heavy dose or overdose unknowingly or without prescribed by the doctor, we ourselves take some medicines, then our body also shows some symptoms, or some problematic symptoms are seen in our body. In this case, what happened? So any chemical that prepared or discovered first tested on these transgenic animals. So here we need to the transgenic animals should be made more sensitive to or towards these chemicals, that they can show the symptoms early. So here the transgenic animals are made so much sensitive towards the chemicals. So this is the biotechnological application in medicine.
And in medicine, here three steps we have studied: genetically engineered insulin, then your gene therapy, then molecular diagnosis. Then in transgenic animals, normal physiology and development, study of disease, biological products, vaccine safety, and chemical safety testing. So next topic is our ethical transgenic animals. How transgenic animals caused ethical issue. Do you know what is the meaning of ethical issue? Ethics means Puran. Ethic means Puran. हमारी culture, हम हिंदू हैं. ठीक है. तो let's start ethical issues. When we are using animals or any other organisms or plants as transgenic, so they have some risk of their life. So here GEAC, genetically engineering approval committee, or genetic engineering approval committee, GEAC, genetic engineered approval committee, its main motive is to guide or some restriction about using the animals, transgenic animals, which we studied, that we have to consider their safety, their importance, okay? And the genetic modified organism should get no harm due to these testings. So here, considering the public anger, we are using in biotechnology those animals which are not so much useful to us. If they are useful to us, then we have to care them so sensitively. So here we will study about GEAC, Genetic Engineering Approval Committee. Next is your, I am telling you about patent. Do you know what is patent? Patent means, suppose I am teaching you this chapter and I will pass a patent bill, this chapter can't teach any other teachers because this is mine, and for that I have to give some money or some other things to the person who will make it final that this chapter is only taught by Vaijayanti ma'am. Okay, so here, as we know, India is a vast country and rice is the most used crop in India. Since a long time, rice is grown in India, and you will be astonished to listen, 200,000 varieties of rice are only growing in India. 200,000 varieties of rice growing in India alone. Are you shocked? So 200,000 varieties of rice are grown in India, out of which what happened, 27 semi-dwarf documented variety of basmati rice was patented by American company. An American company made patent on 27 documented rice, means the rice is grown in India but this is sold by America. So here what happened, this patent bill should be removed for our own benefits. Another example I can give you, the patent bill was applied on neem and turmeric. It means our country have so much large amount of these plants, these medicinal plants, but we can't make medicines on them. The other countries take them from our country, they will make the product and sold us. So our constitution, our constitution amend some bills that are called patent bills. We have to remove these bills, and the products of neem and turmeric should be made in our country. And next is your next topic is our biopiracy. Piracy means robbery. डकैती, पायरेसी. सो व्हाट डू मीन बाय बायोपायरेसी? हाउ वन कैन स्टोल द बायोलॉजिकल प्रोडक्ट्स और एनीथिंग. सो हियर वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड इट इन डीप. रिमेंबर इन इंडिया some of the students' parents means your father also may be work in a MNC. MNC means multinational company. You have to think the company that come from another country establish the company in our country. They uses the soil, they uses the water, leave it, they uses the oxygen of our country, they feel the nature, they use our rainfall, but they are not giving any compensation and they have no authorization to use these resources. So they are damaging our environment also. Okay, so that is called biopiracy. Means when any multinational company uses our resources for which they have no authorization, they are called biopiracy. So nowadays the Indian Parliament has recently cleared the second amendment bill which is worked on the biopiracy and the different patent bills. So this is the completion of your chapter 12 biotechnology and its application. I already sent you the notes and tomorrow we will study our next chapter, that is organism and its population. For today, thank you.